We have seen the main idea of contour integration. Let us look at an explicit example to see how this works out in practice. So our task is to compute the following integral, 1 over 1 plus x squared from minus infinity to infinity. And I know you know the antiderivative, so you can do that by just taking the antiderivative as well. But that's not the point of this video. The point is that you just see all the steps in an easy example. So let us go through the steps. First step, choose a function f of z. Okay, that's pretty obvious here. Just take 1 over 1 plus z squared and choose an appropriate contour. Well, we want to have minus infinity to infinity in the end. So we can take from minus r to r first and then take later on r to infinity. And then we'll have to close the contour in some way. And we see that the function behaves like 1 over r squared if r becomes very large. So we see, well, we can use an upper arc here because probably on this upper circular arc the function vanishes fast enough. But that's how we're going to close, because we see in advance that we get our correct real integral what we want, and we see already ahead that the integral along the big arc is going to zero fast enough for some ML estimate. Now, that was step one, the important step one. Then we are going to apply the theorem of residues. You see the 1 over 1 plus z squared is two poles of order 1, one at I and one at minus I. We see that only the pole at z equals I is within the contour. So we apply the theorem of residues. The integral c total fz of dz equals 2 pi I times the residue at z equals I, because f of z is analytic on and inside the contour except for the pole for the one at z equals I. Now we compute this residue at z equals I was a pole of order 1, so we have the limit z to I of z minus I times f of z. F of z equals 1 over z minus I times z plus I. Those two factors cancel out and we get 1 over 2i. We plug the residue in, we get 2 pi I over 2i equals pi. End of step 2. Step 3, we parameterize LR. Well, that's an easy step here. We can just take z equals x. And then the integral LR fz dz, z runs from minus r to r, so x runs from minus r to r as well. And 1 over 1 plus z squared yields 1 over 1 plus x squared, and dz becomes a dx. So that step is in this example particularly easy. It's usually not too hard, this third step. Step 4, now we have to be careful. We want to get rid of the integral along the big arc. Well, on CR we have the norm of 1 plus z squared. We use the triangle inequality is bigger or equal than the norm of the absolute value of the norm of 1 minus norm of z squared equals the absolute value of 1 minus, well, on CR the norm of z squared equals r squared. So we have the absolute value of 1 minus r squared. We take r big enough such that so we get r squared minus 1, which means that the norm of our function f of z smaller or equal than 1 over r squared minus 1 on CR. And then we can use an ML estimate. If the norm of f of z is smaller or equal than some m on the contour C, and if f of z is continuous on this C, then the norm of the integral smaller or equal than this m times the length of C, where f of z is the length of the curve C. Now we have seen that we can take for m 1 over r squared minus 1, because we have proven that f of z is on the CR smaller than 1 over r squared minus 1. The length of the curve, it's just a circular arc with radius r and then 1 half of the circle, so that equals pi times r. So that means that the norm of the integral along CR is smaller or equal than pi r times 1 over r squared minus 1. And that's step 4. I already see, of course, that if you take r to infinity, then this will vanish. So, final step, combine everything. So, we know the integral along c total equals pi. So, the integral from minus r to r, 1 over 1 plus x squared equals pi minus integral cr f of z ds, dz. Now, the limit from r to infinity from the absolute value equals 0, because if you take the limit over here, you can, for example, use L'Hôpital's rule or divide by r squared in order to show that this limit equals 0. So the limit of the absolute value, the limit of the norm of the integral equals 0. And if the limit of the norm equals 0, then the limit of the integral itself equals 0. So we can take limits on the left and right hand side over here. Then on the left hand side, we get the principal value of the integral minus infinity to infinity equals, and this one equals 0, so we are left with pi. And the integral itself converges. You can show that it's under the 1 over x squared or something like that. The integral itself converges. You know how to show this from real analysis in this case. That means that the principal value equals the integral. So the integral minus infinity to infinity, 1 over 1 plus x squared equals pi. I would have obtained this result via the antiderivative, of course. This video served to go through all of the steps in an easy example. And then in next videos, we will go to much more complicated functions to find integrals of much more complicated functions than this one.